What's up, guys? Barry Gaming here, back with some more AFK Journey, and today we need to talk about the current meta in AFK Journey because, well, the powers of the factions have shifted significantly. We've seen the former, I guess you'd say, tippy-top Maulers, still very good, but now getting trumped out by some of the damage dealers in the Wilder faction, and we really need to talk about this dynamic because, can I be honest, it feels like Lightbearers are extremely, extremely weak right now, and I'm hoping some of these heroes coming in this season might fix that issue. But today we're going to talk about, and we're going to jump into talking about what factions are best, which ones you really want to prioritize, and why this is also an issue, especially when it comes to the Wilder faction. Hopefully you guys enjoy this one. If you haven't done it just yet, hit that subscribe button. Only 30% of you guys have actually subscribed to the channel. Let's jump right into it. So I think we can all agree, when this game launched, some of the most important heroes were actually A-levels, and that kind of still holds true. We still have heroes like Odie that are ridiculously good at bossing, but we also have a couple that have extremely fallen off. Merrily and Corrin especially seem to be ones that just don't really pack the punch they used to. The downside of them too was the fact that you needed to get them to Mythic Plus before they actually became worthwhile, like before either one of them got Mythic Plus. While they could do some damage, they just really, really lacked in the punching power, because mainly because Merrily, of course, gets that huge attack boost. We also have Corrin, who gets that true damage. These heroes were very, very good. Heck, we even had heroes like Arden that still to this day is very good. Again, another hero you really need to get to Mythic Plus, but you still use Arden in control scenarios. But one thing that has really, really surprised me has been the power gains that we have gotten in the Wilder faction. It is absolutely ridiculous. We have Lily Mei, which is hands down one of the most versatile heroes in the game and great in every game mode. And we also have Lenya, which has become very, very strong when it comes to bossing. She can even be viable in PvP. It was weird because, like, our first impressions of her having very limited places to test her in was kind of mediocre. I was like, it doesn't really fit in here, doesn't fit in here. But the second you start adding in combo pieces, like having defense reduction on the bosses, she really starts packing a punch. Beyond that, we have some of the best controlling heroes in the game. I think everybody still has an Eren build to Mythic Plus, and even if you go just a little bit further beyond that, getting that immobilized up to 6 second duration on the plus 10. Very, very strong in combinations with heroes like Arden. And then, of course, heroes like Almas that can extend that duration and be absolutely amazing. Still have one of the really good tanks in the game, Granny, although she has kind of fallen off in recent times. And Heywin, especially, again, another hero. Once you get to Mythic Plus, you get damage reduction to your allies, tons of healing. Very solid support hero to have. Granted, she's not used in a ton of scenarios in things like bossing, but can be very good. Now, that faction, very, very solid still. Maulers as well. You can see how many more Maulers exist. Jeez. They have, again, one of the best budget tanks in the world. We have some of the best supporters in the world, some of the former best healers slash damage dealers with Smokey and Mirky, although he has fallen off pretty hard. And we always see Shakir making a comeback into the meta, being that nice supporter on your team. Lots of good options, some other less than useful. And then, of course, we had Mikkola, which basically replaced Smokey in almost every single situation. They've become very well. The biggest issue I see lately, though, is when you come over to our wish list, my goodness, the amount of A-levels in the Mauler faction isn't as big of a deal. In reality, going for just like Coco and Odie, that is typically the go-to. The rest are kind of like luxury heroes that you want for certain scenarios. The biggest issue to date right now, I think, is the sheer number of A-levels you need from the Wilder faction, and you can only pick two on this banner. You definitely want Damien. Damien is by far probably the one of the best heroes to have for supporters, especially in the early game. When you get in Mythic Plus, his healing just gets insane as well. I use him everywhere. He gives a haste buff. Arden, again, we already talked about why he's so good. And now, because Lenya is not an S level and she is an A level, building Lenya up late is so difficult. I'm even trying to do that on my free-to-play account because we didn't have any diamonds for her banner. Oh my goodness, does it feel bad trying to get copies of this hero. Now, granted, she's an A level, so you're going to get more of them, but you need a crazy amount to actually level them up. That seems to be the biggest issue. And I think it's kind of like a gripe of the current hero wish list, because like there's literally no A-level Graveborn I care about. At this point, too, there really aren't any Lightbearers I care about either. Yes, at one point, Merrily and Corrin were like the go-tos. At this point, we're just trying to get everybody up to Supreme Plus on our account just in case they get good or they get some really cool season ability. Out of all of them, I feel like Lucius is the only one of value right now. And it really sucks that you have to pick two from every faction and you can't just pick like a total of eight over here. Because one thing I like about Epic Recruitment here is you can put any hero from any faction into this list, whether they're A level or they are S level. The biggest issue with the game right now is that every hero I want this A level is essentially Wilder. I want Damien, I want Arden, I want Lenya, I want Olmas. Those four are amazing. Then, of course, I still want Coco and Odie because they are still some of the best bossing damage dealers in the game. But I think that kind of also leads me into the kind of struggle we're having now is because of the buffs that we've gotten in Dream Realm, it's so good. The extra rewards we get from district ranking, in combination with the fact that even if you're not ranked very high, you're getting temporal shards, these actually do add up on our free-to-play. I was actually talking about it with other creators earlier today, that we're getting so many more temporal essence as free-to-play. It's crazy. I have a plus 20 Lily Mei. I have a plus 10 Scarlita, plus 10 Eren, and a plus 10 Arden on my free-to-play. And it's only been going on for like, what, a month and a half or something like that? Like 50 days or something? Absolutely crazy. So there's so many things that are helping us. I really think A-levels are becoming the biggest bottleneck with the factions, because the factions are just getting switched up so much, and the only thing I hate too is the fact that, well, there's only certain heroes that are in here, and the Dream Store is not updating. If Olmas was in here, if Lenya was in here, I would have a completely different outlook on the game, because I'd be like, oh, that actually just makes it easier to build. My biggest complaint right now is because of these power shifts, and the power shift is almost all to the Mauler and Wilder factions right now, It's a bottleneck. We literally can't summon enough heroes in those factions, especially the Wilders, to build the heroes that we actually need. Now let me know what you guys think on this topic. I do think that it is still a big shift. Like Lily Mei, Lenya was probably one of the biggest shifts away from Corrin, Merrily, and even Odie at times. Odie is still used at plenty of times, but it's really just down to like Odie, Coco, and Mikola are like the three go-tos. Occasionally you use Kruger, occasionally you use like Shakir, but like you're always using Lily Mei, you're always using Lenya. Damien is great in so many game modes outside of bossing, same with Eren and stuff. So let me know what you guys think. I really wish we had more ways to get the A level heroes, because that's the biggest funnel when it comes to the Wilder faction. Hopefully you guys enjoy this one. Again, if you guys haven't done just yet, hit that subscribe button down below, leave a comment, let me know what you guys think about this topic as well, and I'll see you guys next time.